The following is a Real World special presentation.
Pedro Zamora, one of the nation's best known names. As educators, he was such a gifted speaker that he often moved his audiences to tears.
Someone who contracted the virus when he was 17. Dedicated tonight, the White House released a statement saying the Clintons were deeply sad.
Doctors say this morning he slipped away from the people.
Pedro Zamora died early this morning at the age of 22.
He's dead at the age of 22.
But his work continues.
Two months ago, while in New York to tape an appearance with CBS This Morning, Pedro Zamora had taken ill. After roughly 2 weeks, he was transferred to a Miami hospital. Pedro has grown steadily worse since his initial hospitalization. He's now gravely ill. Like many young people, Pedro has no medical insurance, and a trust was formed to aid him in paying for his medical costs.
Hi, Pedro. We're here for your benefit today. Here's Mom. We're all here for you.
I've been thinking about you a lot, man.
There were two essential purposes to the benefit. One was to raise money for Pedro's medical needs. Two, the money was not only supposed to go to Pedro, but the money that goes beyond Pedro's medical needs is going into a foundation that's being formed in his name that's going to help out other young people with AIDS and also start educational programs about AIDS and also give money towards research.
I'm here to talk to you about my friend and tell you what Pedro Zamora is to me. And he certainly is a lot of things to a lot of people. Most people know him as a person living with AIDS, or as a heartthrob, or as an educator, an activist, a lover, a friend, a son. And to me, he's mostly a friend. And the things I remember aren't being...
When we left San Francisco, Pedro was in good health, as far as I knew. I guess it just really shows how ignorant I was about the disease, or maybe just how subconsciously I wanted to repress the reality of it. I never thought about it. I never once thought that he would get sick. I just chose to see Pedro the way he projected himself to me, which was that he was very healthy and very alive. I'm very happy.
Get her hand, and you put it right on your heart.
Telling you, going over the line there.
He was fresh. I mean, most of the time, he was just Pedro. You know what I mean? It wasn't like AIDS or nothing, because he was running around and ripping and doing everything everyone else was doing.
When we moved out of the house in June, that was about halfway through the story in terms of Pedro's life and our lives. Oh, Pedro, I love you.
I love you too, babe.
It was like almost like graduation. That's how the sense that I got from Pedro.
You're the right.
It was a mixture of emotions on his part, satisfaction in that it had gone well, and he had met these wonderful people, and the sadness that he was going to be moving out of a house that he had shared for a while and had some great times in. So it was a mixture of emotions. He couldn't wait to come back to Miami. He missed his family, he missed his friends. He said, I'm coming down for a month or so and then to come back to move to San Francisco. So great. Now looking back, he was different. Something was not quite right. He would forget a few things, like forget where our restaurant was. Not totally forget, but didn't know exactly. He was a little disoriented.
Hello.
I asked him how he was feeling, and he had a battery of little infections. He was working on a cold. He had sores in his mouth. He thought thrush was coming back in his chest. It was bad. It was all the warning signs. And he was still doing all these things. He was still speaking.
The fear just kind of sneaks up on you when you least expect it. You know, I go from months where I don't think much about it, and I'm just, you know, I'm working really hard, and I'm going all over, you know, the country speaking. And
he was in San Francisco. He went back to Miami. Then he was in L.A., and now he's flying back to New York to do CBS This Morning. And I told him, you're nuts. Slow down. And he was going to slow down after he did CBS This Morning, and he was going to go to a doctor.
This morning's health segment was sponsored by...
1,000 AIDS cases reported in America just over...
But the irony of it is he never made it.
I received a phone call that he had not made an appearance at a show that he was supposed to do. That really made me worry because he was very responsible.
Finally, we got in touch with CBS This Morning, who said that he had taken sick and he couldn't do it. And he checked into St. Vincent's Hospital in New York, which is probably one of the best AIDS wards in the country. And it was good, but upsetting. He hit bottom. There was something wrong. He was disoriented. And he didn't leave New York for 3 weeks.
When I first met Pedro, we didn't have much to go on than our stereotypes. So I was the medical student, and he was the AIDS educator. And the first night we were living in the house, I learned his story. And I found out that he was this good kid and an honor student and an athlete who had at one point aspired to be a doctor. And I was this good kid, honor student, athlete, and I get to be a doctor. And he gets AIDS. And that one really struck home to me, because Pedro Zamora could have been my colleague, or he could have been my brother, or my best friend, or he could have been me. And we knew that every day, you know, he faced death and uncertainty and sickness, but he always reminded us that he was living. And he said, you know, until the moment I die, I am living with AIDS. So we come here today in love and celebration of Pedro's life and the way that he chose to live. Thanks.
Speak. And he was not going to be able to do this for a while. When it came up that maybe I would step in and take over some of the engagements and speak on Pedro's behalf, Pedro wanted me to do it. And Pedro told me, what I want you to do is to go out and tell people my story.
I'd like to thank you all for coming tonight. And now here's Judd Winnick from MTV's The Real World.
I think that Judd is dealing with this by almost trying to live Pedro's life for him, doing everything he possibly can to make sure that Pedro's work is going to be carried on.
I'm this close to being on The Real World, and I have to live with someone who has AIDS? Why can't it be like on last year's cast? Why can't I live with, like, that obnoxious surfer, the cranky Irishman, or...
It's the only way I can deal with this. It's the only way I can deal with my grief. I could sit back and do nothing, and... If I sit back and do nothing, I know it's going to hit me.
This is my friend Pedro, and this is who would teach me everything I know about AIDS, and he'd teach me a lot about friendship, and he'd teach me a lot about just being a human being.
The most that I learned from Pedro about his childhood was when he recently visited Cuba. He relived a lot of his childhood memories. He was born in a small town near Havana with 8 brothers and sisters.
For me, my brother Pedro is like a, most like a brother, is like a friend. He's like my son and my little one. He represents a lot of my life. We grew up together in the happy family. He's a great mother and a great father.
My parents were against the revolution. What that meant for us was that we were very poor. And in 1980, when the Mariel boatlift happened, 125,000 Cubans came over to the United States, my father decided to leave.
Processing took 5 days to get out of Cuba. On the last day of processing, the government said that the 5 oldest siblings could not go because they were too close to draft age. Pedro's mother and father didn't want to go, but the oldest children said, they insisted that they go so the younger children could have a better life than they had.